Good morning, everybody. I am Anand Kumar Mitra, Assistant Professor English, welcoming you on online class from Uposhor College. As usual, we will learn English second paper. You know, we have been learning grammatical items, and as a part of that, we will discuss today Scolometry 2 SAT. You know, in the last class, we learned SAT 2 Scolometry, and today we will learn just the opposite one, Scolometry 2 SAT. I think who followed my previous class will understand it well, because these two terms are interrelated. One is related to other. So be careful, be attentive, take your khata, pen, and note down the main points. Room number one, you notice sentence beginning with how and what. I think you can remember that in the last class we transform assertiveness into exclamatory by using how and what at the beginning of the sentence. Today we will have to omit that how and what, and the rule will be as this. At first, we will write subject, then verb, then A. You notice A is within bracket. It has a special meaning. If there is A in the sentence, we will use it before verb and after verb. But if there is no article, either A or N, we will not write A here. Then the structure will be subject, verb, verb. But if there is A in the sentence, then the structure will be subject, verb, A plus very or great, then rest of the sentence. When very and when great. If we have a noun, then we will have to use great. But if we have adjective, then we will use very. So I think the point is clear. At first we will write subject, then verb, then A. If there is A or an in the sentence, then we will use A. Then very or great, we will use very in case of adjective, and we will use great in case of noun. So notice whether there is adjective or noun, then rest of the sentence. You notice there are some examples here. What a beautiful garden it is. It is an exclamatory sentence beginning with what, and there is note of exclamation at the end of the sentence. So at first we will bring subject it, then verb is, then article A, then very, then rest of the sentence beautiful garden. Why very? Because beautiful is an adjective. I have already told you, if there is adjective, we will use very. But if there is noun, then we will use great instead of very. Now notice the second example, how fast my hair grows. This is also an exclamatory sentence, because the sentence begins with how and then there is lot of explanation at the end of the sentence. So when we will turn it into a subject, our formula will be subject my here, then verb grows, but we have to omit a since there is no a or an in the sentence, then very, then first. So the answer will be my hair grows very fast. Then number three, what a genius she is. This is also an exclamatory sentence, as the sentence begins with what and there is lot of exclamation at the end of the sentence. So this structure will be same, but we will get a similar kind of structure. At first subject she, then verb is, then a, because there is a in the sentence, then great, notice great. Why? Genius is a noun. Since it is a noun, in that case we will use great instead of very. So some students mistake here. You notice when there will be an adjective, we will use very, and if there is noun, we will use great. I think the point is clear to you. So once again I repeat the structure. At first subject, then verb, then a. If there is a or an in the sentence, then only in that case we will use a, otherwise we will not use it. Then very, if there is adjective in the sentence, then very, and if there is noun, then great, then rest of the sentence. So note it down. I think it will be easier for you if you can keep this rule in your mind, and you should note it down on your khata. Rule number two, sentence beginning with if, would, that, or had. If any sentence begin either with if or would, that, or had, then the structure will be, notice it carefully. At first we will use I wish in place of if or would, that, or had. What we will use at the beginning of the sentence? I wish. We'll use I wish if the sentence begin with if, would, that, or had, and we will omit if or would, that, or had, then rest of the sentence. So it is far more easier than the first one, I think, because we will have to use only I wish at the beginning of the sentence, and then we will write rest of the sentence. So you notice an example. If I were a king, if I were a king, this sentence begins with if. So we have already told we will use I wish in place of if. So I wish, then rest of the sentence I were a king. So the answer will be I wish I were a king. Only if is to be omitted. Similarly, when the sentence will begin with would, that, we will have to use omit this would, that, and in its place we will use I wish. We will use I wish. Then rest of the sentence, would, that, I were a child again, the answer will be I wish I were a child again. Number three, had I been a rich man, had I been a rich man, this exclamatory sentence also begins with had. So I, if, would, that, had, all follow same rule. What is the rule? I wish at the beginning of the sentence, then rest of the sentence, and we will have to omit that either he or that or had. So had I been a rich man, we will use I wish at the beginning of the sentence. We will omit had, then rest of the sentence. I wish I had been a rich man. Students, notice, we in the first two examples we omitted in and would that, but here in this case we will not omit had, rather we will use it after the second subject. I wish I, then this had is to be used here after this second subject. I wish I had been a rich man. So I think this second rule is also clear to you. When a sentence will begin with if, would that, or had, we will use I wish at the beginning of the sentence, and we will omit if, had, or would that, and then we will write rest of the sentence. Rule number 3. Sentence beginning with hurra or bravo. Hurra or bravo. Sentence beginning with hurra or bravo. In that case, we will begin the sentence with it is a matter of joy that, or it is a great joy that, or we rejoice that, etc. Listen carefully. If the sentence or if a sentence begin with hurra or bravo, we will use it is a matter of joy that, it is a great joy that, we rejoice that. We can use any of these expressions at the beginning of the sentence, and we will omit either hurra or bravo, because we will use that expression in place of hurra and bravo. Then we will use rest of the sentence. Notice an example. Hurrah, we have done our job. Hurrah, we have done our job. It is an exclamatory sentence. So we will use it is a matter of joy that. We can also use it is a great joy that, or we rejoice that. Then rest of the sentence, we have done our job. Once again, hurrah. This very expression is an exclamatory expression. We use it is a matter of joy that, we rejoice that, it is a great joy that. Then rest of the sentence, we have done our job. Now notice the second one, bravo. Pintu has defeated Rana. It also follows the same rule. What is the rule? It is a matter of joy that, we rejoice that, etc. Then Pintu has defeated Rana. We rejoice that Pintu has defeated Rana. So we can follow this rule, and if I think you note down this rule on your tata, the rule will be easier. And what is more important here is that you should also practice it at your home. What we discuss on online class, I think, is not enough for to improve your English, to improve your English grammar. What is important is practice. Unless and until you practice it, you can never earn proficiency in English. So, dear students, dear listener, dear learner, be careful, be attentive, and follow all these rules. So this is all from today's class. We will meet once again in the next class. Thank you very much. Have a nice time.